Hello, I'm Ken with Orion Telescopes and Binoculars, and this is one of my favorite products that we've come out with in quite a while. This is the new GiantView BT-100. It's a very large binocular, our biggest binocular, 100 millimeter diameter, that's about 4 inch across, but binocular vision, there's two lenses, and you put two eyepieces on it, and the best feature of all, they use interchangeable 1.25 inch eyepieces. So any eyepiece you've got will attach into this. It uses a compression lock system, which means you can also use filters on this. If you're using this for looking at some nebula, you can put a nebula filter on it, moon filter if you think the moon's a little too bright. So very versatile. Let's get into it and look at some of the features. All right, the first thing is the lens up front, 4 inch, like I said, 100 millimeters. It's got these dew shields on it, which slide back to prevent unwanted glare from the side or to keep the lenses from dewing up if you've got a fairly wet night. It attaches to any photo tripod with a large quarter 20 block down on the bottom. Now, when I say a large tripod, it needs a fairly big tripod. Here I've got it attached to our monster parallelogram. About the minimum you can use with this would be something like our Versigo mount with the L bracket. That's an optional add-on. A standard photo tripod is not really going to work with something like this. First of all, it weighs 14.5 pounds, so it's pretty beefy. But when you're using it on a photo tripod and you're tipping it back to look up in the sky, it gets out of balance because all the weight's on one side. With a parallelogram mount like this, like the Monster, no matter where I point it in the sky, it's balanced because it's rotating in the middle of the axis. So something like this is really what you want for using this for astronomy viewing. If you're just going to be using it for daytime spotting and you have a tripod that's designed to hold at least 15 pounds, then it probably will work if you keep the binocular centered over the top of the tripod like this. On the top of the BT-100 is a large handle here for carrying around. Makes it convenient because, again, it is 14.5 pounds. The highlight, I think, of the binoculars is the eyepiece system in the back. It uses a helical focus for both eyepieces, compression lock, so I loosen it here, the eyepiece slides out, and again, 1.25 inch eyepieces, so any of the Orion eyepieces will work and many others. Which also means you can put filters up front. One of my favorite views when I was trying this thing out was of some nebula. I pointed it at the ring nebula, and I put two ultra block narrowband filters on the front, or on the bottom of the eyepiece, and the contrast just went through the roof, and the object looked really, really detailed and popped out against the background. So I think this in combination with nebula filters would be a really a big win for deep sky observing with both eyes. And then the binocular matches up to everyone's eyes by way of the interocular adjustment down on the bottom here. This large thumb protrusion, you just grab and you push it in or out, and while looking through it, it'll match up to your eyes. It's also geared on the inside, so it always stays flat and level, so you're never looking through the thing at an angle. And the next big feature about the binocular is the angle of viewing. If you see from this angle where the camera is, it's a 45 degree elbow here. That is a really nice compromise between daytime viewing and night sky viewing. We've had previous BT-100s with a 90 degree elbow, which is nice when you're looking straight up in the sky because you don't have to climb underneath and look up into it. But everything that's on the top of the sky always slides down a little bit. So at any point when you're looking up in the sky, you'll be able to use this with a 45. And the best part of 45 is the daytime viewing is very comfortable. Let's say you put this in the room with a view and you're looking out over the mountains or the bay. This is an ideal thing on a tripod for your guests to come over and just look and see what's happening on the distant vistas out there. And having a 45 degree is much more comfortable than looking straight down into a binocular to look out horizontally. So a very good compromise between a lot of astronomy use and a lot of terrestrial use. The BT-100 is also shockproof and waterproof. It's built very robustly. Now, shockproof doesn't mean you can drop this thing. I mean, treat it like camera gear, and it will survive years of use. It just means that it's built really solidly, so if you're bouncing it around in the car, you subject it to a little bit of rough treatment, it's still gonna be aligned when you go out to use it. And it's also waterproof, which means you don't have to worry about dew or misty conditions. That doesn't mean that it's designed to stay outside all the time. If you leave this thing out in the elements for months at a time, the UV light from the sun is gonna start fading the binocular. It's not meant for that, but it is waterproof. It's O-ring sealed, so you don't have to worry about any kind of moisture getting inside when you're using it. One thing about that I wanna mention, if it is a really dewy night and the lenses up front do over, when you take it inside, leave the caps off and let it evaporate off. Because if you thread the caps back on when the dew is on the lens, that dew is never going to evaporate. It'll sit there. And if you've got dew like we do around here with the, you know, the acid dew with some of the pollution, it's going to etch the coatings on the outside of the glass. So make sure it's fully dry before you put it away. The lens assembly itself is a 100 millimeter f5.5, so that's 550 millimeter focal length. So you can calculate whatever power you're going to be using with that formula. It's the focal length of the telescope, 550, divided by the eyepiece itself. It comes with a set of 18 millimeter eyepieces, so that would be about 31 power in this system. And you get about a 2.1 degree field of view. These are nice wide field, 65 degree field of view eyepieces. You'll need a set of eyepieces if you decide to go higher magnification, and they've got to be the same thing. So you can't use a 10 millimeter from one company and a 10 millimeter from something else. They've got to be a matching set. Tens would work to give you 55 power. You can probably go down to maybe a 5 or 6 millimeter in a binocular like this. But I tell you, the best views are the low power, wide field, expansive views of the star clusters and nebula. It's just a beautiful view through the binocular. All right, well, there you have it. This is the GiantView BT-100 Binocular Telescope. Thank you very much. Clear skies.